Okay, so let's go ahead and move into Eclipse. And what I want to do is continue to use that servlet demo project that we had in the previous video. And the first thing I need to do as far as my step one is creating the HTML form. So I'll move to this web content directory. I'll do a right click. I'll choose new and file. So the actual file that I'm going to create here is called studentform.html. And once you're happy with that name, you can go ahead and click on the finish button. So this will give us a very empty file here, or blank file, and we need to add some data here. So I'll first start off with my normal HTML housekeeping. So HTML, and then the body tags, and that's the basic stuff there. And now what I need to do is go ahead and create my HTML form. So with this form, we're going to have action equals student servlet. So we're calling the student servlet, and we're going to use the method equals get. That's the HTTP method that's going to map over to our doGet method in our servlet. All right, so now let's go ahead and set up our HTML form fields. So I'll start off here with the first name, input type equals text, name equals first name. And then I'll do a similar thing here for last name. I'll say input type equals text, name equals last name. So again, remember, these form field names, these are the actual names that you'll use in the actual servlet code for reading that data. So you have to make sure that you use the same names in the servlet code. I'll just copy this line break, put it down here. And then finally, I'll just wrap it up with a submit button. So input type equals submit, value equals submit. And that's basically it for our HTML form. So it's going to send data over to the student servlet and you're going to use the method of get. All right, so this looks really good. Good job so far. All right, so I'll save this file. Now the next thing we need to do is our step two is actually creating the servlet. So I'll move up to this Java resources directory. I'll move down to the package that I created in a previous video, our servlet demo package. So I'll simply right click, I'll say new servlet. So the name I'll use for the servlet is student servlet. So we'll use the same name that we reference here in the actual HTML form. And once we're happy with this, we can go ahead and click the finish button. All right, so over on our far left side here, we have this new student servlet.java that was created by Eclipse, and it generated a lot of good code for us that we can start with. So it helps jumpstart our development process. So up top, we have this at web servlet annotation, so slash servlet. So that's basically the name that we'll use for calling that servlet. We have our servlet class that extends HTTP servlet. We've seen all this stuff before. Let me just clear out some white space here. And this is our doGet method. So this is the method that's called when the actual HTML form submits the data because they're using the method equals get. All right, so let me clear out that auto-generated code and let me write my own code. And just like I did before, I always like to kind of write some comments just to tell myself what I need to do. So the first step is I need to set the content type. And then step two, I need to actually get the print writer. And then finally, step three is where I do my real work. So this is where I generate the HTML content. All right, good. So this is my game plan as far as what I need to do, my work. All right, well, let's go ahead and dig in. So let's start with step one. Set the content type. I use response.setContentType, and I make use of text/HTML. So I'm telling the browser I'm going to send back text HTML data. Then the next step is actually getting the writer. So here I have print writer out equals response.getWriter. And then I simply just do an import here for that package, java.io, because that's where the print writer class is defined. Now, again, step three is where I just do all my real work or fun work here. So clear out some space. And now I need to simply just do out print line, just set up my HTML housekeeping for our HTML body. And I'll just copy this line and I'll do a similar thing here for the slash body slash HTML. So again, just very basic HTML housekeeping there. And now what I want to do is simply send back a response. So I want to say, hey, the student's confirmed, and I want to display their first name and last name. So I'll just write this out here in the code. So here I have the student is confirmed, and now I need to display the student's first name. So I can read that from the form data by saying request.getParameter first name. And then I'll just add some white space there just so we have a space between the first name and last name. And then I'll do a similar thing here for last name, request.getParameter last name. And that's basically it. So lines 41 through 43, that's kind of the real work of this example, just sending back a response. The student's confirmed, first name, last name. And again, we make use of that request.getParameter to read the form data. So just kind of stepping back a bit, here's our method, the main method here, doGet. That HTML form has a method equals get, and it's going to call my doGet method in my servlet. So this all looks really good so far, so good job. Now let's go ahead and test this one out. So to test it, I actually need to view my form. So in the web content directory, I move to the studentform.html, and then I simply right click and I choose run as, and then run on server. All right, great. So here's my form. Form fields for first name and last name. I can go and fill that out with some information, John Doe. And once I'm happy with this, I can go ahead and click the submit button. All right, so I hit the submit button. This made a call to my servlet, and my servlet responded. So it said the student is confirmed, and it displayed the student's first name and last name. So this looks really, really good. I mean, this is exactly what we wanted to do with our servlet. So in this example, our servlet read form data, and it generated an HTML response. So good job with this example.